Bonjour. Bonjour. Hello, I'm Katherine Pettus, Senior Advocacy and Partnerships Director for the International Association for Hospice and Palliative Care, whose vision is a world free from health-related suffering. Your work makes this world possible. I'm going to give you a bird's eye view of the global palliative care movement that you're a part of and which supports you, using some pictures from IHPC's 2021 photo contest and some I've taken myself from different trips around the world. So sit back and enjoy some overseas travel while you can't. This photo from a member in Greece demonstrates the central ethic of palliative care, which is meeting the patient where they are, something I'm sure you do every day. The caption read, "With pain, you are not alone. What you go through, you cannot share with anyone, but you feel the support of the people around you. And in combination with the drugs, you fill the gaps." And you can see that that patient is feeling the support of the psychologist from the interdisciplinary team who's visiting them in the place where their bed has been brought downstairs, because like so many patients, they can't climb the stairs anymore. But we meet people where they are. This one from Pakistan shows Mr. Muhammad Hanif, who's been diagnosed with stage 4 esophageal cancer and was visited and carefully attended, as the caption says, by two young and highly compassionate palliative care nurses serving at St. Elizabeth's Hospital home-based palliative care service with great zeal to provide compassionate care for quality of life to the terminally ill patients at the doorstep while wearing proper PPE. Now we're going to Kenya and we're going to visit Marcus, who was born with a rare genetic skin condition. He needs special bandages to cover his skin and stop the itching and irritation. And our photographer said that this condition has led to financial strain and psychological strain in the family, which I'm sure you're all familiar with too from your families. And the doctors say that Marcus's condition has no cure, but he is the beneficiary of palliative care in Kimbilio Hospice in Kenya, where you can see the wonderful team that takes care of him behind him. Now we're just going to go to another country in Africa called Burkina Faso. And this was the winning photograph from Dr. Martin Lankawandi, who is our advocacy focal point for Burkina, just as Monica, who's your executive director, is the advocacy focal point for IHPC for Canada. And Martin's caption for the photograph said, "This 57-year-old patient has pancreatic cancer, complicated by a pulmonary embolism and permanent 10 out of 10 pain. He does not eat or drink anymore, and his attending physician, who's a gastroenterologist, prescribed him paracetamol for the pain, 1 gram every 12 hours. When I first heard this about 10 years ago from Dr. Ann Merriman, who we're going to meet later, it shocked me into joining this palliative care movement and doing all the work I needed to learn how to support physicians such as Dr. Martin. So going back to the patient, it says, faced with the pain, he refuses any communication with the family, refuses food, and asks for euthanasia, which, as we know, is not legal in many countries, although it's getting more legal in many places. We prescribed him morphine tablets, Martin says, that reduced his pain. Death in pain and people suffering are a daily occurrence in Burkina, and it's time to act against it. And I would just add that it's a daily occurrence around the world, and we are acting against it. Now we're in Pakistan, so we're going to Southeast Asia. And this picture shows a different model of palliative home care in an extreme situation, such as a slum in a lower income country during the COVID crisis. And our photographer says safe distancing and repeated hand washing is almost impractical or impossible to maintain. But you can see she's still giving him the meticulous care, this older gentleman in the bed. And palliative care is our way of doing everything possible for the patient and the family when the hospital tells them that nothing more can be done. We're going to stay in Southeast Asia for this last photograph from the contest, which is from Bhutan. And the caption was, conducting an in-depth interview with an elderly Bhutanese woman diagnosed with chronic lung disease to explore palliative care needs. And just like our first photograph, you can see that the person doing the interview is on eye level with the patient, meeting her where she is, deep listening to explore palliative care needs. Now, this is one of my photographs from Divina Providencia Clinic, which was the only hospice in El Salvador when I was there a couple of years ago. It's run by Catholic sisters, and it's free of charge to patients and families because they serve the poorest of the poor. Like this campesino or peasant farmer from a few hours bus ride away, who's come to sit with his wife in this very humble room in the hospice. The rooms are separated by curtains. It's very rudimentary and basic, but it gives loving and wonderful care to all the people. There's a whole team of qualified doctors and nurses who can conduct continuing education for doctors and nurses around the country. And now there's another hospice in El Salvador that's been built by one of our members that serves private patients, as well as Social Security and public patients. So we're going to a neighboring country here, to Panama. I had to visit Panama for some meetings, and I got to go out with the team to a rural area about 2 hours out of Panama City. And this shows a home visit to a child called Melchizedek. And this nurse has obviously been taking his vitals and will provide the patient as well as the family with what they need to alleviate his symptoms. So this is my final slide, and the picture on the left shows my mentor, Dr. Anne Merriman, the founder of Hospice Africa Uganda, with an incoming class of nurses, medical officers, and doctors who come from all over Africa to learn palliative care and how to make, because they manufacture oral morphine there, for patients in Africa. So when they come to Dr. Anne's house at the beginning of the term, they have dinner, we have dancing, speeches, everyone introduces each other. And at the end, they light each other's candles and they sing, "Carry Your Candle," which is very moving. And that's what you do. You carry your candle to light the way for your patients and families on the sacred journey they're taking. So thank you for your work. And the other picture is my book, which is a self-published collection of blogs, which just show my meetings with patients and services around the world. So be well and have a wonderful conference. Au revoir. Goodbye. See you later. Giga Wabanin.
There is a candle in every soul, some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle, and makes his home. So carry. The hopeless, confused and broken.